years, 3 years, whatever it is. I forgot. Time just goes by so fast when you just enjoy the Lord. But so I just thank you, Pastor Don and Pastor Jordan, for just saying yes and fulfilling the calling on your guys' lives, because this truly changed my life. So going into that, I've gone a lot of ups and downs through things in my journey with Christ, and that's normal. If you're having a consistent upswing every single day for 20 years, then I suggest you to like really take a check at your heart and see how far you are from God, because it says in the Bible you're going to have trials and tribulations. And I found that out going to Bible college. It was just a couple months ago, and I got to a point in my life that I was just getting so caught up with all the busyness, all the work. Yes, it's very important, and I just realized that I just haven't been spending the time that I needed with God, and I was losing that relationship. And I didn't know really what to do to correct it. I didn't know what to do to fix it, and then I was ashamed because I had leaders thinking that I was this awesome man of God, and people think I was this awesome man of God, but really I wasn't. And I just came to the ends and the real of myself that I know there's something deeper because I can feel it, and what I'm doing is definitely not what I want. So I chose to give up the presence of God to complete all the tasks that I needed to do, and I still felt that emptiness. And that's then, right there, I knew I can't sacrifice the presence for anything. I don't care if it's to put me further ahead in life, financially, with education, whatever it is, nothing is more important than the presence of God. And that's what I found out when I went to Jesus 18. And that's why I had Chad talk about it. That's why I had Chad play the video, because that conference changed my life. And for me, I found out there was a deeper love. There's a deeper love. And going into it, we have to step into that love. And in 1 John, it talks about our fellowship. So basically our relationship with God, and how it's saying God is light. And if you notice, light eliminates darkness. Darkness cannot live in light. So if we're walking in the world, we're not walking with God. And we can't be walking with God 30% of the time, 40% of the time, not even 99% of the time. Because that 1% of darkness, God's not in it. So what does that mean? So it goes on to say in 1 John 5-7, this is the message we have heard from him and declared to you. God is light. In him, there is no darkness at all. If we claim to have fellowship with him and yet walk in darkness, we lie and do not live out the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, purifies us from all sin. So what does that mean? Walking in the light just means having a relationship with Jesus. Having a relationship to where you can just go talk to him. Go and place your knees on the ground and just say, God, I am here. I am waiting for you. It doesn't have to be the spectacular event or the spectacular moment or expectation of anything. It could just be you sitting in silence. Just like the prophet Elijah when he just came out of the cave. It wasn't God's voice in the fire, the wind, or the earthquake. It was in the gentle whisper. And so when you are walking in the light, when you have fellowship, when you have relationship with God every single day, you notice, one, his importance and how everything else isn't. And you can take a look at Mary and Martha, that story. You can tell who has the heart for Jesus. And in Mary and Martha, the story basically is Jesus comes to Martha's house, and she opens the door, and she is responsible for being the host. Just like anytime someone comes over to your house, what do you offer? You want a drink? Do you want some food? Do you want a snack? Whatever it is, you try to take care of that person. So it's not that she was doing anything wrong. It's just that she didn't choose the best option, which is to sit at the feet of Jesus and listen. So if you go to it, it says in Luke 10:38-42, as Jesus and his disciples were on their way, he came to a village where a woman named Martha opened her home to him. She had a sister called Mary, who sat at the Lord's feet, listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. She came to him and asked, Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me. Martha, Martha, the Lord answered, you are worried and upset about many things, but few things are needed, or indeed only one. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from her. So Martha is doing something good. She's serving the Lord. She is trying to make his stay there feel welcome, but she did not choose the best thing. Even though it's something good, just like when I was in school, even though I was doing the things that I needed to do to get done in order to pass, in order to come back home, that was all good, but it wasn't the best thing. So I challenge you and I ask you, what are you giving up God's presence for? In your heart, search for it and make time for his presence. It says that Jesus said, Mary chose the best thing. So being in his presence is a decision. It's not something that just happens. You got to decide. You got to have intention. Lord, I am meeting with you today. I feel you. You are pulling me. You are calling me. He calls all of us. It's just we have to have a decision to make and really fulfill that calling, to be with him. And it starts in his relationship, starts at his feet. So like I said, Martha wasn't doing anything wrong. She just wasn't doing the most vital thing. So how corrupt has our hearts become in the busyness, losing the pure adoration of who Jesus is, his person, and so focused on positions, and so focused on our own personal gain, and we're leaving behind the most important thing, which is Christ. And I just ask this generation, like, have we become a generation to only wanting the wants and getting those from Jesus or who Jesus really is? We can't be a generation that continues to fall day after day after day, because we're the next generation to set an impact. The generation in front of us, once they die out, we're the generation and we set the standard. And if we're not following Jesus, the standard is going to be very, very low. And we're going to continue to walk in our lonesome, depression, suicide, pornography, lust, anger, hate. We're still going to have that empty void. So what I'm trying to say is, Jesus is everything that we need. And there is a deeper love. And we can't let positions or reputation or our own appearance to become more than who Jesus is. Jesus died on a cross for us so we could be somebody. Because without him, we are nobody. What's the sense of living life if we're not going to have a purpose? Jesus died on a cross so each and every one of us has a purpose. If you think you don't have a purpose, you have a purpose because you're breathing. You're breathing right here, right now. And he's going to use you in ways to impact all generations. He died on a cross for a reason. So why can't we just get on our knees at least 10 minutes every day and just thank him for that? Yeah, I feel like I'm coming at a lot, but when I came at myself with this stuff, that's when real transformation, that's when real breakthrough happened. When you continue just to go soft at something, you're not going to get better. When you continue to just take the easy way out, you're not going to learn. You're going to keep getting hit with the same things over and over and again. It's all about Jesus in this life. All about Jesus. It's all that matters. And so going into the new year, forget what everything that you have set for goals. Forget everything that you haven't even completed or achieved this year. And set one goal. I want you, Jesus. Because if you get Jesus every single day, I guarantee all the goals in your hearts will begin to be achieved. Because Jesus is everything. And I'm so passionate about this because it took me 2 years to figure out, but I now have a direction. I now have vision. And that's what's going to take everyone to the next level that we're looking for. But the thing is, when you go next level, it's not about you. It becomes about him. And you have a different perspective. And your mind is completely shifted. And now you're not just helping yourself, but you're helping the people around you. And now we have revival happening. So if one of us can sacrifice our life because for Jesus, putting away the things that are separating us from his presence, what can that do if everyone in this room did it? How many more people could you impact for Christ, for the kingdom? How many more people could you speak hope into speak encouragement. Some people are struggling to live one more day. Just think about it. God died for that person. Imagine just yourself. If someone came up to you and said, hey, I'm going to kill your friend, and it was up to you to save their life, I guarantee you wouldn't do it. I know I wouldn't do it. And that's when it came to me, am I willing to die for Jesus like he died for me? And I can have that strength now because of him. So we have to put our agendas away. We have to put our goals away. Keep them. Because when you are focusing on Jesus, miraculously, those things happen. Because when you focus on him, his desires become your desires. Those are your goals. How much farther can you be in life now, just internally, if you focus on Jesus one more day a year? I ask these questions to myself. And it's like me jogging on a treadmill. I can run faster. I can run longer every single day that I'm on a treadmill. But I haven't been on a treadmill in 2 years, so I have to get back to that. So, what kind of generation do you want to be in 2019? We have got to not let the reputation and the positions dictate who we are. It's all about Jesus and who Jesus is. We need to have more people like Mary who are sitting at his feet just listening and forgetting about being the hero, forgetting about being the person that, they have to come talk to me, or forgetting about being the person that has to be involved in everything, forgetting about being the person that just has to be around and have to be wanted and have to be noticed. It's not about that. Life is so shallow when it's about that. You wanna know why? Because everything is pointing back at you. You make up 0.00000000 times affinity 1% of this world. It's not about you. But Jesus died for every single one of us on this world. So when we start hitting our knees to the ground, when we start just praising, when we just start getting in his presence and choosing him every single day, that's when our lives are changed and transformed. So I was just sitting in my room the other day, and God just really spoke, and he said, you're always sacrificing something in your life. It's either going to be your desires or my presence. And that takes me into Matthew 15. And this is talking about Isaiah back in the Old Testament when he prophesied to the nation. And they talked about, in verse 8 says, these people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. Where's your heart? Are we just going to be a ministry? Are we just going to be a generation that comes here only on Sundays to worship with our mouth? Or are we going to let God work through us and we're going to worship him with our hearts every single day? Because that's what it's got to be about. And I'm saying this not just to say your life will get better. I'm saying this because there's a love that's so deep that only God can fill. Only God can take you in. That's why I'm saying this. That's why I'm so passionate about it. Because when you start feeling that love, nothing else in the world matters. And you feel so wanted. And you feel so loved. And you feel so joyful and excited. Even how bad things are going, you feel like you have a purpose. You feel like you have a reason to keep pushing. There is a deeper love. And we're only going to figure that out and find that is when we start seeking Jesus every day of our lives. There's no other way. So I will die preaching this gospel because I have tasted the love. And when you taste something of Jesus, fully Jesus, you will never, never turn away. Ever. You just want more and then more and then more. And he's so good, he gives you more and more and more. And then pretty soon you're walking with him. You're walking in the light. So what is taking you away from his presence? Because it says in the Bible, the only thing that matters when Jesus comes back is the people who gave their lives to him. So what that means is the only thing that matters in this life, in this world, is our relationship with Christ. Nothing else. Because he's looking forward to coming back to us, for us. So our relationship is the most vital thing that we could ever have with Jesus. And we cannot go a day without it. We cannot. Because every single day, God provides his presence in a new way. Every single time. And every time your alarm goes off, before your alarm goes off, he is longing for your heart, calling you, just be with me. Before you pick up your phone to look at dumb social media about who's doing what and who's saying what and who cares about the Kardashians, before that happens, before you start playing video games, throw all that junk away. Because God is calling for your heart. It's not just for pastors. It's not just for people who read the Bible. It's not just for people who worship him. It's for everyone. And then when you start falling in love with him, then you read more of his word. Then you start to worship him more. You have to just fall in love with him. Because he's calling and longing for you. The only achievement that matters in life is your relationship with him. So how do you do this? In 1 John chapter 1, it talks about how when they had time with Jesus, they were just consumed. They gazed at him. They gazed at his teachings, at all the things, all the miracles that he did. And they used the word gazed. And that comes from the theater. Like when you're watching the theater, that they're just so consumed with what's happening in front of them, they have nothing, no idea what's happening around them. That is experiencing Jesus. When you can just go and be with him and not have to worry about what time it is. You don't have to worry about what to do. It's going to be hard at first, but if you continue to do it, it becomes easier and easier. And don't measure the success of your experience with Jesus based on time or what he's did or what he says or anything like that. Just know that you're there in his presence. Just like Mary, she just sat and listened. That's all. And when you start to do that, he cleans you. He purifies you. That's when your heart starts to burn for him. And then worship team, if I have you, come up. Your heart begins to burn. That's when you find the deeper love. And I just pray for people who have just fallen into the same path as me, that they find a deeper love that I have found. I pray for people who are far beyond me to find a deeper love. I pray for people who haven't even known Jesus to find a love. It's all about his love. So in 2019, don't make that year about anything else. Why dedicate the year to get a new car? Why dedicate the year to lose 15 pounds? Why dedicate the year to get all A's? Why dedicate the year to get a brand new pair of shoes or 15,000 likes on an Instagram? Why dedicate a year to get more followers? Why dedicate a year to get more materialistic things that just ruin? Yes, those things are good. I'm not saying they're bad. But dedicate the year to Jesus. And just watch how he uses those things. Watch how he uses those gifts that he's given you. There's gifts that you haven't even unrevealed yet because you don't even know the deeper love of God. And I found that out today. I don't know what this opportunity is going to have me stepping in, but all I do know is it's going to take me deeper with God. And more gifts are going to come out. So I just humbly just say, become all you can, only in the Lord. Forget about yourself. Forget about the people around you. Start searching Jesus with your spirit, that what he has given you, because there's only one thing, there's a hole in your heart, and only Jesus can fill it. Because we're so obsessed with this word and what is going to take place, and it's revival. We're so obsessed with it, but we don't do the things that we need to do to get it. And it's more than just revival. It's also a life lesson as well. We just expect things to be given to us because we want them. But God reveals secrets to those who seek Him, not just want them. So in your life, seek Him every day. And this whole message is just birthed out of my weaknesses. So I pray that God just points out a weakness in your heart. I'm not trying to impress anyone. I'm not trying to encourage anyone and for a day. I'm trying to encourage someone for a lifetime. Because there is eternal life waiting. And it only is going to happen when you know Jesus. He will clean you. He will purify you. And He will start letting your heart burn for Him. There is a deeper and greater love that Jesus wants to take every single one of you in today. And there is a deeper and greater love than what you experience now, going to want to take you in tomorrow. And then when you step into that one, there's a deeper one He wants to take you in the next day. It gets better and better and better. And the best thing is that love waits for us every day, whether we want it or not. So it's our decision to sit at His feet, because revival of your soul only awaits in Him. Revival of your soul is only at the feet of Jesus. So we're going to have the altar workers come over up to the side. And I just encourage you, if you have anything that you need prayer for, use them. That's what they're there for. Don't be afraid. That's only going to stop you from going deeper to Jesus. And then there's some people in here that's never even experienced the love of God. And that's okay. You don't have to feel behind. You don't have to feel ashamed. That's how it starts. I didn't know what the love of God was when I first came. But I had two passionate people that felt the call of God on their life. And sacrificed to be with Him. And it planted a seed in my heart. So that's all I ask. Is just open your hearts to a deeper love. And it's the only love that you'll find in Jesus. So if I just have everyone bow their heads. And if you have come in this place, and you don't even know who Jesus is, you don't even know what that love feels like, and you want to, I just pray that God just overwhelms your heart right now. That He just grabs it with His hand. And you can feel the grip of His hand on your heart. And you just hear the words, "I love you." He wants to show you that love. So if you are one of those people and you want to give your life to Him, you want to make your life all about Jesus, this is your moment. You never know when you're going to get another moment. So if you want this love that I'm talking about, you want to experience it, can only experience it in your own way, because He has called every single one of us in our own unique ways. So He has something so much different for you than what He does for me. But His love is miraculous. His love consumes us. So if you want that love, just raise your hand when I count to three. And what this is, it's just telling Jesus that, God, I've just come to the end of myself. and all I want is you. I accept you as my Lord and Savior, and I want to experience this love. So if that's you, just raise your hand in 3, 1, 2, 3. His love consumes you. His love consumes you. You put your hands up. That love right there is the start of something beautiful. It's the start of something you'll never get tired of. You'll never come to end to. It's forever going for eternal. Another question is, for those who have given their lives to Christ, but you know you haven't been living your life the way you should. You know that you have been sacrificing his presence for something that is less. Everything is less. Like me, I'll be straightforward with you and clear and transparent. I think it was 4 weeks ago at the conference, I rededicated my life to him because I knew I wasn't sacrificing what I needed to. I was sacrificing his presence instead. I want all of him. If that's been you, there's no shame. No one's judging you. Don't let that stop you. If that's you, just raise your hand at 3. It's 1, 2, 3. That's great. Just put your hands down. That is the most beautiful thing that you could even decide on. You guys chose to be a Mary. You just chose to be a Mary and sit at his feet. So as we continue, we're only going to go for just a few more minutes before we get started with all of our extra activities. But let's actually come sit at his feet. Just right up here during worship. And let's just worship him for just a quick couple minutes. And just really talk to him. Just let him reach your heart. And ask him to take you deeper. Because if you ask him and you're seeking him, he will take you deeper. So the altar's open, guys. You can come up.
The more I seek you, the more I find you, the more I find you, the more I love you, the more I seek you, the more I find you, the more I find you, the more I love you. Oh, I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lean back against you and breathe. Feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep. It's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace. It's overwhelming. It's overwhelming. The more I seek you, the more I seek you, the more I find you. I always find you. The more I find you, oh, the more I love you. the more I seek you with all my heart, the more I find you. Cause you're not hiding far from me. The more I find you, the more I love you, Jesus. I want to sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe, and feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I'm melting your peace, it's overwhelming. And I want to sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace, it's overwhelming. Overwhelming. Sing it out one more time. I want to sit at your feet. I want to sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and just breathe, feel your heart beat for me. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace, it's overwhelming.
Lord, we just come to you. We just say, have all of us, God. Clean us, God. Show us areas in our life that we can just put away, to set aside so we can focus more on you, to experience the love that you truly have for us, God. I pray, Lord, that you just sweep through this place, God, and you just hold on to every single heart with your love, that a greater adoration just increases, greater hunger increases within our souls, just calling us, longing to be with you, God, for who you are, because that's all it is. You are enough for us, Jesus. Help us, God, just seek you daily. Come against all the temptations that just want to take us out of your presence. And allow our hearts just to be totally dunked in your love. Holy Spirit, just come with your strength. Come with your love. Come with your joy. Come with what every heart in here needs. And touch. We love you, Jesus. We honor you. We will forever worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. This is relationship with Jesus. This is what it is at home. Take this home every day. So, band will stay up here as people are going out, but we're going to be starting dodgeball soon. So if you haven't signed up yet, just come ask me and I'll get you on a team. But just to let you guys know, there will be pizza, and that is going to be out in, it's in the cafe. So it's going to be through these doors out to the left. So if you've signed up, you can go get some pizza. If you haven't signed up, come see me first and then go. And if you still need prayer, our prayer team is over there to help you with anything that you need. So we love you guys. We will see you next week and bring back someone with you.